I watch you from my eyes, I'ma love you, you see. And the way you are whining, and the way you are going, they say the man, I'ma try to rush you like the bird and stop. Yo, but baby girl, will you be mine? Let go, show your skin, because you're one of a kind. Me not gonna lie, girl, I must be in love, cause the way you are going, you have my car top. Girl,
feeling blessed up, on that dress up. Ain't afraid to show it, I'll expose it if I dress up. Riding in that Tesla, roasted ketchup. Sipping on, till I'm messed up like yes sir. So now I'm getting changed, people looking at me strange. Like switching lanes, never change to the same. We get paper, you f***ing on papers. We walk around with lasers, you probably own some tasers. Blame. Disgrace us, they girlfriends won't date us. Got different, I'm pimping. You can tell by my pay stub. My getting right, with
I'm going wild for the night. Being polite, I'm going.
Been a while out for the weekend. Me, myself, and I, my three friends. Pillar broke it and leaf thin. ASAP, finna sneak in.
Finger to the critics. Me and my.
From the Joseph J. Gentile Arena on the campus of Loyola University of Chicago in Chicago, Illinois, this afternoon on this Super Bowl Sunday 2014, here on LoyolaRamblers.com, it's Loyola Ramblers women's basketball. Today it'll be the host Ramblers coming in overall 8 victories and 12 defeats on the year, but they do have a 500 record in the Missouri Valley Conference coming into today's game at 4 victories and 4 defeats. Tough opponent today. It'll be the Indiana State Sycamores visiting the Gentile Arena here today. Indiana State coming in 12-7 overall, but they have won 7 of 8.
Good afternoon,
Missouri Valley Conference
games.
Now
to
Pat Schultz
University
for the pregame introductions here from the Gentile Arena.
The Missouri Valley Conference women's basketball featuring the visiting Indiana State Sycamores and your Loyola Ramblers. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask you please rise, kindly remove your hats, and join the Band of Wolves with the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, let's meet the starting lineup for the visiting Indiana State Sycamores. At forward, a 6'2 sophomore from O'Fallon, Missouri, number 3, Marina Laramie. At forward, a 6-foot junior from Dallas, Texas, number 25, LaShonda Littleton. At forward, a 6'1 junior from Mansfield, Ohio, number 34, Rachel Mahan. At guard, a 5'4 senior from Springfield, Massachusetts, number 10, Bilkis Abdul-Kadir. And at guard, a 5'10 senior from Indianapolis, Indiana, number 33, Anna Munn. The head coach of the Sycamores, Terry Morin, assisted by Joey Wells, Sarah Riedemann, Rhett Wiersba, and DJ Slifer. And now, the starting lineup for your Loyola Ramblers. At center, a 6'3 freshman from Glen Ellyn, Illinois, number 3, Kate Soane. At forward, a 6'2 junior from Auburn Township, Ohio, number 15, Molly Crosby. Junior from Grove City, Ohio, number 24, Ariel Beavers. At guard, a 5'8 senior from Farmington Hills, Michigan, number 32, Lindsay Booker. And at forward, a 5'11 senior from Detroit, Michigan, number 21, Troy Hambrick. The head coach of the Ramblers, Cheryl Swoops. Assisted by Janine Wazalewski, Keisha Newell, and Chrissy Dizan. The trainer is Ashley Schultejohn.
And there you have the starting lineups for this afternoon's ball game here on this Super Bowl Sunday 2014. Hi, everybody, and good afternoon. My name is Tom Westenfeld, joined by our producer director, Russell Roberts, and also our great RoyalRamblers.com video crew. And before we go any further, let me apologize for the voice as we're getting toward the late winter, and it has taken its toll the past few days. So I ask your understanding, and hopefully you'll be able to put up with hearing my happy tone for the next couple of hours. Sound like nails on a chalkboard. Anyway, Indiana State coming out in their royal blue uniforms on the road here are the Sycamores with the white numerals are, and the Loyola Ramblers coming out. They are in their home uniforms, the white jerseys with the gold numerals. We're about to get started here. Rachel Mahan on the opening tip for Indiana State. And she is going up against Kate Soane, getting the start today for the Ramblers. And here's the opening tip, and we are underway this afternoon from the Gentile Center. Glad you've joined us here, the Gentile Arena. Indiana State controlling. Opening tip. Moving around the perimeter into the right corner. Here's LaShonda Littleton. Back around on the left side. Well, thoughts of a three there from Anna Munn, but she didn't take it. There's Bilkis Abdul-Kadir. They'll lob in low left, knocked away, and the Ramblers able to come up with a loose ball. Lindsay Booker able to get to the loose ball, and the Ramblers able to force a turnover on their first defensive set of the game, and now they'll have a chance at their first points of the afternoon. Ramblers coming off a loss on Friday night in their game against Illinois State, but they pick up the first points of the game here as Troy Hambrick able to give the Ramblers the early lead. Troy Hambrick coming in averaging 17.4 points per game. Ramblers have the first 2 points of the game on the board. Indiana State working it in low left, and a short shot goes in. And we are tied at 2. I was shielded by the official here from where I sit at courtside. Has the 2 points credited to Rachel Mahan. But the Ramblers come right back, and Lindsay Booker with the three. So the Ramblers have a 5-2 lead. So Indiana State operates in the front court. Indiana State, as you watch on our LoyolaRamblers.com video stream, going right to left. Here's Abdul Qadir out front with a three, and that's in dead center. Bilqis Abdul Qadir coming in averaging 13.5 points per game. Drains the three-point shot there, and we're tied at five. Ariel Beavers operating in the front court. Worked the top of the key now to Molly Crosby. Back around to the right side. Hambrick dribbles inside the three-point line. Little trouble there. Shot clock down to six. Bounce pass in the lane. Turnaround shot that'll rim around and in. Kate Sohn able to get the roll around the iron for the 2 points, and the Ramblers have a 7-5 lead. Abdul Qadir in the front court now. Dribbles near the top of the key. Right side, LaShawn Littleton. Trying to work it in deep, ball knocked away, and the Ramblers able to come away with a steal. Good defensive work early in the game here by the Ramblers. They work it down low, and a short shot goes in. Troy Hambrick down low, takes the nice pass, and is able to drop it in. And we have a quick timeout, a 30-second timeout. 17:28 to go here in this opening half, and the Ramblers with a 9-5 lead. Boy, good transition possession there. So we take another look. Troy Hambrick taking that long pass, going in deep and able to bank in the shot. So the Ramblers starting out right now at 4 of 4 from the floor. While Indiana State at 2 of 3, 66.7%. Ramblers, as we said, coming off the loss on Friday night to Illinois State, 65-54 was the final here at the Gentile Arena. Troy Hambrick at game high, 22 points in that game. And she was able to, with that point total, to extend her streak of games of at least 20 points or more to 6. So Indiana State now operating in their front court, facing their largest deficit here, but very early in the game. Well, they work into the left elbow. Laramie had it for a moment. Back out left side, and here's a three-point shot in dead center for Bilqis Abdul Qadir. So that's her second three ball of the game. And Loyola the lead now at 9-8. Ramblers find Molly Crosby down low, but she's unable to get the shot away. Work it back in deep again. Sohn able to bank it in down low. Kate Sohn makes it an 11-8 Rambler lead. So Kate Sohn with a couple of early baskets here in the ball game. Indiana State, as we said at the top of the broadcast, coming in having won 7 of 8 games in the Missouri Valley Conference. Abdul Qadir holding out front. No wide right, a three ball. That'll miss off the heel of the rim. Sycamores with the offensive rebound. Follow up. That'll miss there for Anna Munn. Ramblers able to get possession. They're quickly into the front court. Drop it down low again, and I think we're going to have a travel called here. Yep, Kate Sohn took the pass in the lane, got called for the steps, and it'll be Sycamore basketball. 16-18 to go here in the opening half. 11-8 in favor of the Ramblers. There's Bilqis Abdul Qadir in the front court now. Munn out front between the circles. Well, Abdul Qadir making a couple of threes so far, but Anna Munn leading the way with 43-pointers coming into the game for Indiana State. 9 to shoot, Abdul Qadir fed it baseline right, 15-footer. Actually a little less by Mahan, that'll miss. Ramblers able to get possession. Long jump pass, Molly Crosby all alone. Great assist by Ariel Beavers. And Crosby able to get the finishing hoop. And the Ramblers the lead by a score of 13-8. There's Abdul Qadir in the front court, up to the right side now, Littleton. Back around wide left. Here's the left elbow jumper. That'll miss for Abdul Qadir. And the rebound goes to Molly Crosby. Ramblers on the run into the front court. Lob to Kate Sohn, spinning and hitting. Kate Sohn spins and drops it in with a right hand off the glass. Ramblers able to build up an early 15-8 lead. So Loyola now able to increase their lead to 7 points over the visiting Sycamore Ball Club. Here's about a 13-footer in the paint. No good there by Anna Munn, but she draws a foul, our first foul of the game. This will be on Ariel Beavers. So Ariel Beavers with her first and the team's first, and we have a timeout on the floor. 15-01 to go in the half, and the Ramblers lead 15-8. Back after a break on LoyolaRamblers.com.
There's a world you discover inside the classroom, and then there's a world waiting right outside it. You can read about diverse cultures or live among them. You can listen to a lecture about the Great Lakes or jump in one. From Loop to Lakefront. Now that's a quad. Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
Takes up a whole city block, yet it can't be seen. What we're building is 176,000 square feet, yet it can't be measured. What we're building houses 12 state-of-the-art operating rooms, yet it can't be confined within walls. Because what we're building at the new Loyola University Hospital Tower is a new vision of patient care that looks at the healing process from the eyes of the patient. This is where medicine is headed, and this is only the beginning.
Back here at the Gentile Arena as we come back in a month, an 89.1% free throw shooter going to the line, and the second free throw goes in. She made the first just before we came back out of our break, so it's now a 15-10 ball game in favor of the Loyola Ramblers. Ramblers so far in the game, 7 of 7 from the floor. Can't start out any better than that. Ball loose here left of the key. They dive for it. Troy Hambrick comes out of it with possession. Ramblers are bringing out near the timeline and reset. Shot clock at 10. Three from the right. Air ball. So there's the first missed shot of the game. Indiana State coming back in transition. Abdul Qadir flipped it back. Right wing. Three ball. That's actually near the right point than the wing by Munn. It missed anyway. And the rebound goes to the Loyola Ramblers. Lindsay Booker with a rebound. Now they work it down low. Sohn again all alone underneath, and she lays it in. Holly Crosby on the assist, and the Ramblers have a 17-10 lead. So LU back up by 7 again. Abdul Qadir to the hoop, runner banked in. Great move to the basket there. That's her first two-point hoop of the game. Rambler lead down to 5 now at 17-12. We hit the 14-minute mark, time remaining here in the opening half. Down low, a little hesitation. And I believe that'll be ruled out of bounds, and it'll be Indiana State with possession either way. Kate Sohn worked it in deep and went too far down toward the basket, and I think stepped over the baseline, and it'll be Sycamore basketball. 13:55 to go here in this opening half. Indiana State at that last timeout, 3 of 8, so they would be 4 of 9. Check that 4 of 10 officially now. From the floor in the ball game. As now we have everything squared away. I think we had a shot clock issue there, and we're back at it here at Loyola University in Chicago. Abdul Qadir around the screen by Mahan. Now Mahan in the lane, spins, fires, misses. Offensive rebound, and then a whistle in deep. And it'll be Loyola getting the basketball after an Indiana State turnover. Ramblers to move it all the way left to right as you watch here on our LoyolaRamblers.com video stream. Ariel Beavers across the line. Hambrick takes the fall off the ball there, but no foul. The possession continues. Beavers with it back. In the lane, Hambrick. The turnaround might have been partially blocked on the way up. It came up short. Hambrick able to get to the loose ball in the left corner. Passed it out front, and then two Ramblers bump into each other. And that allows Jasmine Greer just into the game to get a steal for Indiana State. Also just into the game is Chelsea Small for the Sycamores. As right now they're looking to cut into the Rambler lead. Small setting the screen out high. Shot clock at 13. Greer circles around to the left. And the shot banks no good. Rebound on the floor, and Lindsey Booker has it for Loyola. Ariel Beavers now. Picked up at the timeline there by Anna Munn. Here's Sohn out high. Sohn looking in deep. Nobody there. Swings it on the wing. Hambrick brought it back out high again. 8 on the shot clock. Bounce pass back into Hambrick. Troy with a turnaround. Off the glass, no good. Rebound out of bounds. And it'll be, I believe, Indiana State basketball. Marina Laramie coming back into the game now after a rest on the bench here for Indiana State. And coming into the game will be Katie Fott here for Loyola. Katie Fott, the junior guard from Wilmette, Illinois, went to Loyola Academy. Fott coming in, the team's leading three-point shooter, 32 threes. Coming into this afternoon's game as here's a turnover by Indiana State and the Ramblers to get it back. So the Ramblers preserving what right now a five-point lead. See if they can take advantage of that turnover and add to the, able to pad their lead. Fought right side for the three, a rainbow right through. Nothing but net for Katie Fought. Boy, right on cue, she comes into the game and drains the three, and the Ramblers able to bump that lead up to 8 points now at 20-12. Abdul Qadir gave it up now to Greer. First shot in the circle. Missing, rebound baseline right, went to Anna Munn. Work it back into Greer, out front. Abdul Qadir pulls up, 13-footer. Air ball, but she's able to draw the foul, and it looks like we'll have free throws coming up here for Bilkis Abdul Qadir. Foul was called on Katie Fott. Her first and the team's first. And we have a timeout on the floor. 11:37 to go here in this opening half. Timeout on the floor with a score. Loyola 20, Indiana State 12. Back after a break on LoyolaRamblers.com.
A handshake. It's a simple gesture. It can greet an old friend or make a new one. It says, welcome. Best of luck. I'm here if you need me. It has the power to make a new place, well, feel like home. You're always among friends at Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
Show your school spirit and make all the difference. Sport your team's colors at the MVC tournament and get your all-session tickets for all 9 games for as little as $35. Don't miss the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Tournament at the Family Arena in St. Charles, Missouri. Show your school spirit and get your tickets now.
These two teams have had 5 previous meetings. Indiana State with a 3-2 edge in the Lifetime Series coming into this game, although it's been a while since these two teams met. And it's the first time they have met as conference rivals. Bilkis Abdul Qadir able to make the first free throw as we come back. It's her first made free throw and her first attempt of the game. Second one goes in. Abdul Qadir, 74.7% from line, and she makes two there. It's a cross-court pass now, and Katie fought with a three, rattling it out. Bad luck there, and Chelsea Small, the Indiana State rebound. Abdul-Qadir, the transfer from Memphis, back out front. Three ball goes in for Chelsea Small. Chelsea Small, her first points of the game, and her Himmler lead sliced down to 3 at 20-17. They work it again outside. Left Becca Smith, who came into the game during that last timeout, receiving the pass, but fouled off the ball, and I think it'll be on Molly Crosby. Yep, her first and the team's second. I was watching the ball, but in my peripheral vision, saw a couple of players take a tumble in the lane there, and Molly Crosby called for the foul, and so Indiana State can tie with a three-point field goal this trip up the floor. Here's Munn around to the right. Now back with it, Natasha Zurich into the game for the first time. Shot in the lane, partially blocked by Troy Hambrick, and as she comes back up the other way, Natasha Zurich will get called for a foul.
First team foul.
Zurich with her first. And that is the first on Indiana State. Ramblers with three team fouls so far in the ballgame, So far in this contest, officials letting them play. Here's Troy Hambrick down the lane to the hoop, laid it in. Troy Hambrick with six in the early going. Ramblers back up by five, 22-17. Hilkis Abdul-Qadir off to the left side of the front court. Pulls up at the foul line. Oh, nearly walked. Right side now, Zurich. Off to the left around the high screen by Laramie. Shot clock at 12. Into the lane, trying to spin there where the ball was Laramie. Lost the possession. Laramie arguing that it got tipped out by the Ramblers. And the officials agree in Indiana State to keep possession. Abdul-Qadir to inbound the ball. She looks. Brought it in right side and an immediate three. A little bit short there by Small. Rebound in the lane and a tie-up situation here. It'll be a jump ball. And on the alternate possession, it'll be Ramblers basketball. Good defensive work there by the Ramblers to force the tie-up situation, force the jump ball, and the Ramblers will get possession as we approach the halfway point of the opening half. Pressure here defensively by Indiana State. Ramblers quickly into the forecourt. Hambrick on the drive to the hoop, and she gets the two. Troy Hambrick with eight. She said she averages just under 17 and a half a game. Off to a good start. Here's at the other end a lay-in by Bilkis Abdul-Qadir. She's off to a tremendous start. As it's now a 24-19 ball game. Abdul-Qadir with a dozen points in the game here in the early going. Ariel Beavers into the forecourt for the Ramblers. Here's Hambrick wide right. Hambrick pulled up against a double team, lobbed it in the lane. Ball loose, knocked out of bounds, and the Ramblers to keep it with nine on the shot clock. Becca Smith to inbound. She looks. Winning a while. Hambrick off the inbound. 14-footer, good. Troy Hambrick. Having her usual impressive performance here today. And the Ramblers lead it now by seven again, 26-19. The drive by Zurich. She cannot convert. The Ramblers coming back the other way. A little traffic jam there at the timeline. The Ramblers able to bring it across. Nice screen set there by Hambrick. Now Troy has it in the lane. Spins and hits. Now Troy Hambrick has a dozen. Tying her for the game tying. Game high honors. And it is now a 28-19 ball game. Zurich left side, swings it left to the key, shot clock down to 12. Here's Munn, moved it off a little, boy, an almost nondescript screen there. The shot does not go in. Small set that screen, it was very subtle, but it got the job done, but Indiana State couldn't convert. Ramblers back the other way now. Chance to pad their lead. Moving the ball well around the perimeter. Now in here's low right, Crosby. Shot no good. Indiana State with the rebound. Chelsea Small getting the board. And out front, a three-point shot. No good by Small. Molly Crosby, the Rambler rebound. And as she brings it up court, we have a 30-second timeout. Got 7:44 to go here in the opening half. We'll stay here. The Ramblers with a lead by a score of 28-19. Indiana State right now with 6 of 20 from the floor. Ramblers at 13 of 18, and we've gone to a full timeout. So we'll step aside. Ramblers lead 28-19 on LoyolaRamblers.com.
There's a world you discover inside the classroom, and then there's a world waiting right outside it. You can read about diverse cultures or live among them. You can listen to a lecture about the Great Lakes or jump in one. From Loop to Lakefront, now that's a quad. Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
And make all the difference. Sport your team's colors at the MVC tournament and get your all-session tickets for all 9 games for as little as $35. Don't miss the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Tournament at the Family Arena in St. Charles, Missouri. Show your school spirit and get your tickets now.
Back at the Gentile Arena, 7:44 to go here in the opening half. The Ramblers with a 28-19 lead, and we've talked about Troy Hambrick getting off to a great start here, and take a look at some of the early highlights for Troy in the ball game. Able to take the pass down the lane and get the layup there. As it is a Rambler lead of 28-19, as the announcer is unfazed here at press row. Ramblers moving the ball around well. Crosby left of the key, missing. And the rebound goes to Bilkis Abdul-Kadir. Kadir into the front court. Swings it in the left corner, driving in deep. And a little drop back pass under the hoop. And we have a whistle. Got a foul called here on Molly Crosby. That'll be her second. Team's fourth. Troy Hambrick back into the ballgame now here for the Ramblers. 7:16 to go in the half. Ariel Beavers ready to come back into the game. Quick shot off the inbound. Will not go for the Sycamores, and the rebound goes to Katie Fought for the Ramblers. Fought on the run up ahead into the front court to Becca Smith. Here's a long three from the left that'll miss. And on the rebound, it'll be out of bounds to Indiana State. 7:06 to go in the half. 28-19, Ramblers in front. Bilkis Abdul-Kadir brings it into the front court. Off to the right side, Stephanie Whitman just into the ball game now. Circles around left side, pulls up. There's the block by Hambrick. Indiana State able to keep possession. And a Munn with it out front. High screen set by Laramie. Munn, the runner. That'll be no good. Rebound down low. And getting to it, Ramblers able to get possession. Kate Sohn able to get the ball under the basket. Ramblers, let's see if they can add to their lead here. Pass down low, contact here, and I think they're going to call a foul on Rachel Mahan. So Mahan the foul. Her first and the team's second. We were talking about it earlier, not a lot of fouls in this game here in the early going. Hambrick off the inbound. Cannot convert, rebound in the lane. Boy, what a battle for the rebound there and a foul in deep. I'm going to call this on Marina Laramie. Laramie with her first and the team's third. Ramblers do inbound on the baseline to the left of the hoop. Pass way out front to Becca Smith. Smith guarded by Munn. Right side, Beavers. In the lane now to Sohn, 13-footer. Off the heel, no good. And a rebound goes to Laramie out near the foul line. Here's Kadir into the front court. Abdul-Kadir up to the right, has it back top of the key. 6:05 to go here in the opening half. Ramblers lead 28-19. Lob in low left. Double team there. Good defensive work again by the Ramblers. Laramie couldn't get the shot away. Shot clock at 10. Out front, Munn. Munn. Right side, Abdul Qadir. Pulls up at the elbow. Whistle and a foul here. And it'll be on Ariel Beavers. It'll be her first and the team's fifth. And Stephanie Whitman to inbound. That'll refill the shot clock here for Indiana State. A couple of substitutions ready to come in for the Ramblers. Here's the drive in the lane, 13-footer. That'll be in and out for Stephanie Whitman. And on the rebound, the whistle. And it'll be out of bounds here to Indiana State. Katie Fought and Lindsay Booker back into the game now here for the Ramblers. 5:39 for the half. Ramblers with a lead, 28-19. Becca Smith into the front court. She moved into the front court against no defensive pressure. Ramblers, pass out front, stolen away. Good anticipation there by Munn. And at the other end, lays it in, and she takes a tumble after the shot. Anna Munn, good anticipation there. Saw the pass, went forward, got the steal, and it paid off, and it's now a 28-21 ball game. Ramblers by 7, closing in on the final 5 minutes of the opening half. Boy, Fought was moving her feet all around there before letting go with a pass, and now a foul on the lane. I think they'll call this on Mahan. Rachel Mahan with a foul. Her second, team's fourth. Here's Natasha Zurich back into the ball game. And also coming back in is Chelsea Small. So the Ramblers with a full 30 to shoot, exactly 5 minutes to go in the half. Hambrick off the inbound lob. Just barely hit the front of the rim, rebound tipped out, and the Ramblers to keep possession. Ramblers right now at 13 of 22. Indiana State really struggling, 7 of 25 from the floor in the ball game. Here's a left side three, and in dead center for Becca Smith. Becca Smith with her first points of the game, and the Ramblers have a double-digit lead. They lead at 31-21. Natasha Zurich into the front court. Munn left side, off to the right. Oh, nice pass down low, and then the spin shot will not go for Chelsea Small, and the rebound out of bounds to the Ramblers. Boy, right now Indiana State really struggling just to put the ball in the hoop. And the Ramblers have taken advantage here this afternoon. Into the front court now. Ramblers control. Turnaround by Sohn in the lane. In, out, and back in again. So Kate Sohn able to hit the shot. She's in double figure. She has 10. Ramblers, the lead in double digits at 12 now at 33-21. There's a pull up and another block. And then as they go for the loose ball, heavy contact, one of the Sycamores winds up on the floor. And it'll be a held ball, and on the alternate possession, Indiana State to keep it. Bilkis Abdul-Qadir back into the ball game now. Here's Reagan Smith into the game as well for Indiana State. Her first appearance of the ball game. Smith, the freshman forward from Sullivan, Indiana. So the Sycamores to inbound, 15 is posted on the shot clock, 4:02 for the half. Abdul Qadir, pass down low. Good work again by the Ramblers defensively. Whitman was gonna take the shot in deep, but the Ramblers denied the shot. But then Abdul Qadir hits the three from the left side. Her third three ball of the game. Makes it a 33-24 ball game. Ramblers in front. Well, the Ramblers, having won the first 15 minutes of the half, if you will, as Hambrick spins and hits again. Now let's see if they can win the final 5 minutes and really give Indiana State something to think about during the halftime break, as the Ramblers lead it right now, 35-24. Here's Munn out front, guarded by Fought. Right side, Whitman. Abdul Qadir for three. That'll be a round and out. Rebound offensively went to Reagan Smith down low, and a whistle and a foul in deep. Foul will be called here. It'll be on Becca Smith. And Becca Smith with her first, team sixth, and we have a timeout on the floor. 3:13 remaining here in the opening half, and your score, the Ramblers 35 and Indiana State 24. And we'll be back after a break on LoyolaRamblers.com.
Show your school spirit and make all the difference. Sport your team's colors at the MVC tournament and get your all-session tickets for all nine games for as little as $35. Don't miss the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Tournament at the Family Arena in St. Charles, Missouri. Show your school spirit and get your tickets now.
There's a world you discover inside the classroom, and then there's a world waiting right outside it. You can read about diverse cultures or live among them. You can listen to a lecture about the Great Lakes or jump in one. From Loop to Lakefront, now that's a quad. Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
At the Gentile Arena. Ramblers right now at 16 of 26 from the floor, while Indiana State at 8 of 29. As 3:13 remains here in this first half, and the Ramblers out front 35-24. Ramblers trying to hand Indiana State what would be their second Missouri Valley Conference defeat of the year. As we resume the inbound pass, and went into Chelsea Small and wound up going out of bounds in the corner. And Indiana State will keep possession. Whitman off the inbound. Back to Abdul-Qadir. She'll take the three. It's in. Yet another field goal for Abdul-Qadir. Abdul-Qadir. Ramblers lead at 35-27. A little bit of pressure here defensively by Indiana State, but the Ramblers able to move it into the front court. We are under 3 minutes to go here in the opening half. Fought, got it in low right, quick passing in deep. And a foul down low. This will be on Stephanie Whitman. Whitman with her first and the team's fifth. And going to the line will be Troy Hambrick here for the Ramblers. First free throw of the game for Troy goes in. Hambrick, 75.3% from the line this year. That was the first free throw of the game for Loyola. Second free throw, and that'll be in. Hambrick hit the second of the two, hit them both. Chelsea Small now coming back into the ball game. Reagan Smith coming out here for Indiana State. 37-27, Ramblers by 10. Here's Bilkis Abdul-Qadir into the front court. Small, one bounce dribble. Guarded there by Sohn, left side now Whitman. Heavy contact off the ball, and they're gonna call, I think, Bilkis Abdul-Qadir with a foul. Yes, they will. That'll be her first and the team's sixth. Ramblers get it back. The Ramblers have played outstanding defense here in this game. Going to say earlier on they'd won the first 15 minutes of the half. Let's see if they can continue on and win this final five. Wide right, fought for three. That will not go. Rebound, bobbled underneath the hoop, but Whitman able to secure control. Abdul-Qadir out front. in the lane. Small spins and hits the bank shot. So Small with her second field goal of the game. She had a three-point shot earlier, giving her her total of five, with a Rambler lead at 37-29. LU into the front court. Pass off to the left, though, stolen away. Bilkis Abdul-Qadir with a steal. She'll bring it into the front court. Back around, out front, straight on three. That'll miss for Small. Rebound out of bounds, and it'll be Indiana State ball. Casey Johnson in the game now here for Indiana State. And now Ariel Beavers checks back into the game here for the Ramblers. 1:40 to go in the half. Ramblers up 37-29. Here comes the inbound. Down low and the short shot in. I believe it was by Chelsea Small. Got shielded on the view, and it was Chelsea Small with a basket. Ramblers up now 37-31, so Indiana State. Little bit of momentum here as we approach the halftime break. Hambrick able to bring that pass in and lays it in. Boy, the Ramblers were on the edge of turning the ball over there, but Hambrick kept at it and wound up getting the 2 points. Ramblers the lead, 39-31. Here's Abdul-Qadir into the front court for Indiana State. Munn out front, guarded by Beavers. Johnson now with it. Back to Small. Little wraparound pass down low, knocked away, and the Ramblers come away with possession. Lindsey Booker wound up with it. Wings it up ahead and out of bounds to Indiana State. Kitty fought. I think she thought that was not going to be tossed her away and was going to go into the corner and had to try to stop and readjust and come back for the ball. Couldn't quite do it. So we're under a minute for the half here. Indiana State controlling. Kick it out wide left. Abdul-Qadir for three. That's an air ball. Ball loose under the hoop. And it'll be out of bounds to the Ramblers with 38 seconds to go in the half. So a full shot clock here. So we'll have 8 seconds difference between the shot clock and game clock. Long pass into the front court. Sohn rockets a ball into Hambrick, and Troy Hambrick with a left-hand lay-in. Troy Hambrick makes it 41-31. LU back up 10 again. That'll turn the shot clock off for the rest of this opening half. As we're down under 20 seconds remaining. Small left side, Abdul-Qadir out front. Has it out between the rings. Nine to shoot. Nine for the half. Down to five for the half. Here's the 16-footer. In and out, and then it bounced off the front of the rim. Ramblers get the rebound, and that'll bring us to the end of the half. Great first half here by the Ramblers, and they have a double-digit lead going into the halftime break. Your score here at the end of the first 20 minutes, Loyola 41, Indiana State 31. Pause and return after this break. This is Loyola Ramblers women's basketball on LoyolaRamblers.com.
There's a world you discover inside the classroom, and then there's a world waiting right outside it. You can read about diverse cultures or live among them. You can listen to a lecture about the Great Lakes or jump in one. From Loop to Lakefront, now that's a quad. Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
What we're building takes up a whole city block, yet it can't be seen. What we're building is 176,000 square feet, yet it can't be measured. What we're building houses 12 state-of-the-art operating rooms, yet it can't be confined within walls. Because what we're building at the new Loyola University Hospital Tower is a new vision of patient care that looks at the healing process from the eyes of the patient. This is where medicine is headed, and this is only the beginning.
What we're building takes up a whole city block, yet it can't be seen. What we're building is 176,000 square feet, yet it can't be measured. What we're building houses 12 state-of-the-art operating rooms, yet it can't be confined within walls. Because what we're building at the new Loyola University Hospital Tower is a new vision of patient care that looks at the healing process from the eyes of the patient. This is where medicine is headed, and this is only the beginning.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your halftime entertainment, we have the Children of Uganda, Tour of Light. Ladies and gentlemen, the Children of Uganda, Tour of Light.
And we're back at the Gentile Arena here as we are about to begin the second half of this afternoon's ball game. As the Ramblers score a 41-42 in Indiana State. And before we go any further, we want to alert the audience. There was a basket.
Those days are gone.
It was originally about the memories on the wall. Games before they return home to face Northern Iowa on the 21st of February here at the Gentile Arena. We are next to RoyalRamblers.com, a locally produced webcast as we are underway here in the second half of the game. Ramblers going as you watch on our RoyalRamblers.com video stream from right to left. There's a little lead here. It'll be no good by Harry L. Beavers, and the rebound goes to Indiana State. Sycamores going left to right here in half number two. Kees Abdul-Kadir into the front court. Has it back after Laramie had it for a moment. Directing traffic off to the right. Munn fakes the shot, then lets go. Cannot convert. Rebound to LaShonda Littleton. And Indiana State will keep the possession alive. As we said, Indiana State right now 11 of 35 from the floor. Really struggling here shooting-wise in this game. There's a right elbow jumper that'll bank no good for Littleton. But Indiana State with another offensive rebound, and they'll have perhaps a third chance at it here. Say perhaps barring a Rambler steal or a turnover by Indiana State. Littleton out front. Left side to Munn. And now here's a three that'll rattle off the right side of the rim for Laramie. No good, and the Ramblers wind up with possession. So three attempts, and Indiana State cannot come up with any points. Ollie Crosby holding out front. Has it back. Grambler's playing a little catchy on the right side. And the foul line jumper, a little bit short. Rebound tipped around and winding up with it. There's Rachel Mahan. Indiana State in transition. And a Munn had it left side. Here's Abdul Qadir. Qadir hands it off. Mahan had it for a moment. Now back out front to Munn. Abdul Qadir off the left side. Bounce passing low left. And after a little bit of a tenuous catch there, Mahan tried the turnaround. That didn't work out, and the Ramblers wind up with possession. So Indiana State continuing to struggle here from the floor in this game. And we have had no points here so far in the second half of this game. Maine's a 41-30 ball game in favor of Loyola. There's a long lob down low to Hambrick. Blocked down low there. Good play defensively by Mahan for the rejection. Indiana State back the other way. Well, good ball work here and the shot from the wing. That'll miss for Abdul Qadir. Ball loose, baseline left, and it'll be out of bounds to Loyola. Or do we have a foul here?
Sycamore foul.
Got a foul on Mahan.
Rachel Mahan. Third personal.
Rachel Mahan.
First team foul.
Her third and the first team foul of the second half for Indiana State. And the Ramblers to get it back. Right now, both teams are throwing a second half shutout. We remained at 41-30 in this game. A little bit of a high dribble there, nearly a carry, but Rambler is able to keep possession. Sohn near the elbow, wheels around. Work it back into Cade Sohn, dropped it in deep to Hambrick. Nice work defensively on the double team. Pass tipped high in the air, and coming out with it is LaShonda Littleton. Up ahead to Abdul Qadir, and she lays it in.
Bilkis Abdul Qadir.
That gives her 18, I believe, in the game as they took that point off the board on that shot at the 3:04 mark of the first half. That would have reduced her first half output to 16. Check the halftime box here on that, as a matter of fact. Actually, no, it's 19. As she had 17 points in the half, and that was after the change in the scoring. Injured player here for the Ramblers, and we're going to have a timeout taken. For the Ramblers, they've been beset by injuries all year long. And we're going to step aside during the injury timeout as we took a look at that last play. 16:47 to go here in this second half. And the Ramblers have the lead, 41-32, as you take a look there. Rambler in distress will step aside and return on the on LoyolaRamblers.com.
Handshake. It's a simple gesture. It can greet an old friend or make a new one. It says, welcome. Best of luck. I'm here if you need me. It has the power to make a new place, well, feel like home. You're always among friends at Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
Rambler fans, did you know that by joining the Rambler Varsity Club, you are directly ensuring the future success and growth of the Loyola Athletic Programs? Your support helps provide championship-level experiences for student-athletes through educational support, facilities upgrades, and providing each team with the tools they need to succeed. Please join the Rambler Varsity Club and share in the success of the Rambler Athletics community. Become a member today by calling 773-508-3321 or join online at LoyolaRamblers.com.
Caputo Cheese Market has just the cheese you're looking for. With over 1,000 cheeses from around the world, Caputo Cheese Market supplies only the finest and freshest cheeses at wholesale price. Caputo Cheese Market also offers a full-service deli, a sausage shop specializing in homemade sausages. The market also has a focacceria that sells pastries, cannolis, cookies, and more, plus specialty food items from Europe. Caputo Cheese Market is located at 1931 North 15th Avenue in Melrose Park, just north of North Avenue on 15th in Melrose Park.
Rambler fans, did you know that by joining the Rambler Varsity Club, you are directly ensuring the future success and growth of the Loyola Athletic Programs? Your support helps provide championship-level experiences for student-athletes through educational support, facilities upgrades, and providing each team with the tools they need to succeed. Please join the Rambler Varsity Club and share in the success of the Rambler Athletics community. Become a member today by calling 773-508-3321 or join online at LoyolaRamblers.com.
Caputo.
All right, back here at the Gentile Arena, Troy Hambrick, the injured player for the Ramblers, being helped off the court after a considerable time on the floor here. We'll try to get you a report as soon as we can as the game resumes, as the Ramblers with a lead by a score of 41-32. We've had just 2 points here in the first, 3 minutes and 20 seconds of the second half. So a rather difficult offensive start for both teams, and the Ramblers turning it over. Good play by Littleton for the steal. Brought it back out high right, and the three-point shot that'll rim out for Chelsea Small, and it'll be Rambler ball. Quick drive in on the left edge of the lane there, and a whistle and a foul. One of the Sycamores taking a tumble there. Call the foul on Anna Munn. Anna Munn with her first and the team's second. Take another look here. Munn reaching across the front there, taking the fall and got charged with a foul as well. It's always a tough situation to take when you take a hard fall and then you get charged with a foul, as Kate Sohn with a little right hand spin shot. It goes in, and the Ramblers lead at 43-32. So Loyola, their first 2 points of the second half coming almost 4 minutes in. Now whistle here. See what the call is going to be. 15:55 to go. And it looks like we have a timeout on the floor. 15:55 to go here in the second half. And the score is Loyola 43, Indiana State 32. Back after a break on LoyolaRamblers.com.
Footer, swish-a-roo, and he's got two. There's Al Frederick Hughes, 20-footer, swish. 8 points for Al Frederick the Great.
Talking earlier, this is the sixth all-time meeting between these two teams. Indiana State with a 3-2 advantage through the first five games. Sycamores having won the last two meetings, taking the most recent by a score of 102-71. That was back in 2006.
Checking in for the
Ramblers' last victory in the series came way back in 1997 in a 63-62 win. Sycamores controlling after the timeout now. Shot clock is under 10. Littleton right side, out front now to Munn. Back right side, and the three from the corner. Air ball there. And it never drew iron. The second shot by Small before the shot clock expired misses. Ramblers the rebound there in transition. Long pass ahead. Booker in from the left and cannot get the shot to go through, and the rebound to Chelsea Small. Abdul-Qadir pulling up, about a 14-footer right through Bilkis Abdul-Qadir. Coming in averaging 13.5 points a game, Abdul-Qadir is, and she drains the shot there. That gives her 21 in the game. 43-34. Ramblers in front. They have led virtually the entire way.
Sycamore foul number 10, Bilkis Abdul-Kadir.
And Bilkis Abdul-Kadir getting called for a foul there. Her second and the team's third now. And the Ramblers to inbound under the hoop here. To our right, to your left as you watch on the video stream. Kate Sohn with a little leader in traffic. And it rolls over the front of the rim and through for Kate Sohn. She had 10 of the half. He has 14 in the game. 45-34, Ramblers up top. Ramblers trying to bounce back after a tough loss on Friday night. It was a close game Friday night, and then Ramblers let it get away late. Abdul-Kadir with the shot. Boy, that took a, boy, that just deadened off the back of the rim and fell through the basket.
Timeout.
And we have a timeout taken, I believe, by Indiana State. 14:36 to go here in the second half.
30 seconds.
And it's a 30, so we'll stay here. 45-36 is the score. Good to see Troy Hamburg coming back into the game here for the Ramblers during this timeout. Boy, when she was injured, I was watching the ball and did not exactly see what happened to Troy. She was on the court in the corner, and the arena here was completely silent. But Troy back into the ball game and ready to get back at it here. It's 14:36 remaining here in this second half. Our next RoyalRamblers.com webcast will be coming your way on the 21st of February. That'll be a Friday night. Ramblers against Northern Iowa. A 7 p.m. start here on RoyalRamblers.com. Ramblers after today with just four home games remaining. Down the stretch, the schedule as far as the home road balance is not in their favor. Ramblers will be on the road for most of the rest of the way. Here's a pass into Hambrick. She's fouled, I believe, from behind.
Sycamore foul number one, Chelsea Small.
It'll be on Chelsea Small.
Fourth team foul.
That'll be the fourth team foul. Small with her first of the game. And they'll refill the shot clock. Cheryl Swoops, the head coach of the Ramblers, saying that her team has time. And they take their time, and it pays off as Troy Hamburg with a two-pointer off a nice feed. 47-36. Ramblers back up by 11 now. Boy, you get the feeling, though, Indiana State, they are too good of a team not to make a run. There's too much time remaining, and there's a three from the right that's in for Anna Munn. Anna Munn, 13.4 points per game coming in. She has seven this afternoon. We have 13:49 remaining here in this second half. Ramblers to inbound here with 24 to shoot. Down low, Hamrick, little reverse layup attempt that will miss, wouldn't have counted anyway.
Rambler
foul was called on Troy as after Troy she got the ball, she went under the basket.
Personal, first
her first and the team's first. Boy, the Ramblers in the first half went a long time without getting called for a foul. The same applies here in half number two. So Indiana State trailing 47-39. Boy, a little contact off the ball there, but the game continues on. Abdul-Kadir out front, 12 to shoot. Now down to 10 on the clock. Back out front, Abdul-Kadir again, 5 on the clock. Off to the left around the screen by Laramie, and then a whistle.
Rambler foul number three, Kate Sohn.
Kate Sohn got called for the foul.
Second team foul.
Her first and the team's second. And Bilkis Abdul-Kadir to the line here now for Indiana State.
Shoots two.
She is 2 for 2 from the line in the game this afternoon. Chance here to cut into the Rambler lead, and she sinks the first free throw. She had 17 at the half.
Number 21.
And now with 24 in the game.
For the Ramblers, number 15, Molly Crosby replacing Kate Sohn.
Molly Crosby back into the game now for the Ramblers. Kate Sohn comes out for LU. Here comes the second free throw. Right there. So that makes it a 47-41 Rambler lead. And as I said, Indiana State, too good of a team for the Ramblers to get too secure too early.
Sycamore foul number 21, Casey Johnson. First
Ramblers
person.
On the possession, able to draw a foul from Casey Johnson. Her first and the team's fifth. So Troy Hambrick to inbound, near sideline if you're watching on our LoyolaRamblers.com video stream. Here's the drive in from Becca Smith. Back out to the right side, Katie Fott. Fott, a little trouble on the dribble. Well, that would look like it was close to either a travel or a double dribble. Ramblers keep the possession going, 13 to shoot. In the lane, turnaround, and in for Ariel Beavers. Ariel with her first 2 points of the game. Ramblers up eight now, 49-41. Anna Munn left side, got it in the lane. Tough shot, right-hander, will not go. Well, there was a great shot there by Laramie, but she got bad luck. Rambler and then as they went for the rebound,
Troy Hambrick
called for the foul. Her second, team's third. Boy, good move there on the lane, as you see, by Laramie, just would not go
Chelsea
in.
Chelsea Small shoots two.
Chelsea Small got the rebound and drew the foul. Small to the line shooting two. And her first free throw. The rim out.
For the Ramblers, number three, Kate Sohn replacing Troy Hambrick.
Small, another free throw upcoming. She had 7 points at the half, has yet to score in the second half. Chelsea Small, another one on the way. Second free throw. That's in. So Small converts on the second of the two, makes it a 7-point game, 49-42 in favor of Loyola. Boy, what a screen in the backcourt there by Molly Crosby, who took the fall. Ariel Beavers into the front court. Fought, open out front, decided not to take the three. Sohn, left of the lane. Now back out front, 12 on the shot clock. In the lane, Beavers, nice fake, shot will not go. Rebound to Chelsea Small for Indiana State. Here's Abdul Qadir into the front court. Flipped it wide right to Munn. Back around to the left side. Boy, what a drive in there by Casey Johnson, but her avenue was shut off. He's swinging it back around to the right side. And the shot in and out there for Chelsea Small. Rebound to Molly Crosby. Ramblers in transition. Becca Smith in on the right. Cannot finish, banking it no good. Small the rebound. Sycamores back the other way. Abdul Qadir, pull-up jumper from the line. Off the left rim, no good. And the rebound goes to Becca Smith for the Ramblers. So a little streak here of several possessions where neither team able to score. Beavers off to the left around the screen set high by Sohn. Little wraparound pass and in the lane, Crosby spins and draws the foul. And Molly will go to the line here.
Sycamore foul, number one, Chelsea Small.
They called the foul second on Chelsea person. Small.
16 foul. There's
and that'll be her second and the sixth team foul. And we have a timeout on the floor, 11:22 for the second half. Right, Ramblers up 7, 49-42 on LoyolaRamblers.com.
Show your school spirit and make all the difference. Sport your team's colors at the MVC tournament and get your all-session tickets for all 9 games for as little as $35. Don't miss the 2014 Missouri Valley Conference Women's Basketball Tournament at the Family Arena in St. Charles, Missouri. Show your school spirit and get your tickets now.
There's a world you discover inside the classroom, and then there's a world waiting right outside it. You can read about diverse cultures or live among them. You can listen to a lecture about the Great Lakes or jump in one. From Loop to Lakefront, now that's a quad. Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
cyberspace that's dominating today's goings on as we come back here. 11:22 to go in the second half. 49-42 Ramblers. And again, my thanks to all of you putting up with my voice here today. It's been quite a week. And I appreciate your understanding. It's Molly Crosby to the line here for the Ramblers. And the first free throw goes in. Molly Crosby had 2 points in the half. That was her first second half point of the ballgame. Crosby with another one coming up. Second one. That's good. Molly Crosby drains them both. That makes it a 51-42 Rambler lead. We've had two ties and no lead changes in the game. Abdul Qadir out front. Here's Munn driving in. Little hesitation. Cannot hit the shot. Offensive rebound. And then a second shot here. Rainbows in. Casey Johnson with the basket. Johnson, her first points of the ball game. Rambler lead back to 7 at 51-44. They have had innumerable 7-point leads in this game. Here's a kick ball in low right, and the Ramblers to keep it. Casey Johnson kicking it out of bounds. Rachel Mahan back into the game now for Indiana State. Marina Laramie coming out for the Sycamores. Here's the inbound, 19 to shoot here for the Ramblers. And after the ball was inbounded, we had a quick whistle. Foul off the ball, and I believe it'll be on Kate Sohn. Yep. Her second, team's fourth. And it'll be Sycamore basketball. So we approach the halfway point of the second half. Nice pass in the lane, then spinning. Rachel Mahan there spun almost a little bit too quickly. Ball got knocked away, but Indiana State able to keep it with 15 to shoot. Here comes the inbound. Brought into Abdul Qadir. Shot clock under 10. Right side, here's a three for Johnson. That'll be off the iron, no good. And the rebound out of bounds to the Ramblers. The Ramblers lead by 7. Indiana State now 5 of 18 from 3-point range in the game today. There's a loose ball and then a quick whistle. Loose ball was not connected with the foul that was called here. Rachel Mahan on the foul for Indiana State. Her fourth and the team's 7th, and that'll put the Ramblers into the bonus. And so going to the line here will be Kate Sohn for the Ramblers. So one and a bonus here for Kate Sohn. Sohn, 55.6% from the line, and misses that first one. Bad luck there, it went in and out. Chelsea Small, the Indiana State rebound. Here's Abdul Qadir driving into the lane. Split two defenders and draws a foul. Called that foul on Becca Smith, that'll be her second. 5 against the Ramblers here in this second half. Reagan Smith now back into the game here for Indiana State. A little bit of a wait on the inbound, but Sycamore is able to start the possession without a problem. We're under 10 minutes to go here in the second half. Boy, the penetration, the pass into the lane, knocked away. Scramble for the loose ball, and Becca Smith came away with it for the Ramblers. Here's Ariel Beavers. Guarded by Johnson. Beavers directing a little traffic out high right. Molly Crosby. Left side now to Kate Sohn. Sohn picks up the dribble. Guarded there by Reagan Smith. Lob in low left. Spinning into the lane. No shot available. Shot clock at 3. And here's the shot by Beavers. Short. Rebound tipped out of bounds. And the Ramblers get it. Boy, Casey Johnson was right there looking to pick up the loose ball, but it went out of bounds. She was the last to touch it, and the Ramblers get a little bit of a break after they had to toss up the shot in the last second. Stephanie Whitman back into the game for Indiana State. Inbound pass to Crosby, and her shot blocked out of bounds. And the Ramblers will try once again. Katie Fott coming into the game now here for the Ramblers. So Ariel Beavers coming out. Becca Smith to inbound. Brought it into Sohn. Nice fake. Shot will not go. Rebound to Smith. Follow up. Partially blocked there by Small. Ball loose left side. They dive for it. Now we have whistles. They call the foul on Chelsea Small. Small with her third, team's eighth. And Kate Sohn back to the line here, shooting one at a bonus. Kate missed her first free throw attempt a few seconds ago, and that one in, out, and back in again. Kate got a little bit of a break there. Counts just the same. Ramblers up 52-44. Second free throw is in. Sohn converts. She has 16 points this afternoon. Ramblers have the lead, 53-44. Here's Abdul Qadir. We get out front. Left side, Whitman. Small, fakes, drives, went into the air and draws a foul with 8:37 to go. Foul on Kate Sohn, her third, team sixth. And free throws coming up for Chelsea Small here for Indiana State. Small is 1-for-2 in the game from the line this afternoon. First one here is in. Back into the ball game now, LaShonda Middleton and Marina Laramie for Indiana State. Here comes the second free throw. And that'll be in. So Small, after missing her first free throw of the game, earlier in the second half, she's made three in a row from the free throw line, and it's a 53-46 game. Yet another seven-point lead. Boy, I'd like to count up how many of those we've had today for the Ramblers. Indiana State has never led in the game. They've tied it twice. Whistle here and a travel on Kate Sohn as she went under the hoop along the baseline. It'll be Indiana State ball back. Troy Hambrick ready to come back into the game at the next stoppage for the Ramblers. Elkis Abdul Qadir into the front court. Abdul Qadir swings it around to the left side. Back out front now in the lane. Heavy traffic there. Laramie took a fall, and I think she got called for a walk. And actually, well, we had a foul call there on Marina Laramie. Her second and the team's ninth. Heard someone yell travel there in my headset and thought that was what the call was going to be, but either way, the Ramblers with possession. Winding down now towards 7.5 minutes remaining in the ball game. Lindsey Booker wide left to Crosby. Got it into Hambrick, low left, hook pass back to Crosby, down the lane, laid it in. Great play there by the Ramblers, perfect execution. Ramblers up 55-46. Elkis Abdul Qadir into the front court. Right side to Littleton. Back out front, Laramie in the lane. Turnaround shot, and that'll rim out for Chelsea Small. On the rebound, whistle here. And I think we have a foul on Indiana State. We're going to take a quick timeout and return. 7:17 remaining, and the Ramblers
lead 55. There's a world you discover inside the classroom, and then there's a world waiting right outside it. You can read about diverse cultures, or live among them. You can listen to a lecture about the Great Lakes or jump in one. From Loop to Lakefront, now that's a quad. Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
What we're building takes up a whole city block, yet it can't be seen. What we're building is 176,000 square feet, yet it can't be measured. What we're building houses 12 state-of-the-art operating rooms, yet it can't be confined within walls. Because what we're building at the new Loyola University Hospital Tower is a new vision of patient care that looks at the healing process from the eyes of the patient. This is where medicine is headed, and this is only the beginning.
Before the break, it was Laramie being called for a third personal foul. And it's the team's 10th, so the Ramblers into the super bonus now, so they'll get the mandatory two every time they go to the line. And Molly Crosby to the line here now for Loyola. Molly 2 for 2 from the line in the ball game today. Both of those came in the second half. Now she's 3 for 3. Molly 2 points at the half. And now she has 7 points this afternoon. Here comes the second free throw. Curled over the front of the rim and in. It's not the first free throw for the Ramblers today that is. Had an interesting journey around the rim as we have a whistle here as Indiana State working it in deep. And a foul here called, and I think that will be on Lindsay Booker, and it is. Her first, team seventh, that moves Indiana State into the bonus. Ilkis Abdul-Qadir back to the line now here for Indiana State. Free throw on the way and in. She'll get the back end of the one in bonus. First time in a while she scored a point. 57-47, Rambler lead at 10. Second free throw, good. So Abdul-Qadir now with 26 points in the ball game. Rambler lead at 9 at 57-48. A little bit of pressure defensively here by Indiana State, but the Ramblers have it safely in the front court. Under 7 minutes to go in regulation. Ariel Beavers, left side not a fought. Guarded by Munn. Crosby. Right side, Hambrick, 7 to shoot. Hambrick to the hoop, lays it in. Troy Hambrick with 24. Ramblers up now by 59-48. Rambler retake an 11-point lead.
Shooter! Shooter!
Abdul-Qadir in the corner. Oh, bounce pass in low left now. Spin shot no good by Mahan, and the Ramblers able to get the rebound. In transition, lob over Troy Hambrick's head and out of bounds. And it'll be Indiana State with the ball back. Hambrick, I don't know if you noticed there, she was going for that ball and her momentum nearly took her into the basket support. She had to put on the brakes really quickly and she was able to react well to avoid a collision. It is padded, but still, when you're running full steam ahead into that padded basket support, that can never be easy. Here's the turnaround. It's in. Count the hoop and a foul call on Rachel Mahan to the line. After the foul called on Molly Crosby, her third, team's eighth. Mahan to the line for the three-point play opportunity here for Indiana State. So Mahan looking to make it it would be an 8-point game. So we have 6:02 remaining here in this second half. Mahan the free throw, it's in. That gives her 5 points in the game. And it's now a 59-51 ball game. Fought from the left, had thoughts of a three, didn't take it. Out front, Beavers. Now right wing, little bouncer in from there, from Booker into Hambrick. Her shot in the lane, that's rejected. Littleton coming away with it into the front court. Now she'll hand it off to Bilkis Abdul-Qadir. Now a three from the right, that'll miss off the heel for Munn. Ramblers with a nice defensive rebound there. They'll bring it back the other way. 5:20 to go for regulation. Hambrick up top. Looking around. Finally starts the dribble. Hambrick to the hoop. Lays it in again. Troy Hambrick with 26. Ramblers back up 10, 61-51. Abdul Kadir. Wide right now, Littleton. Circling around, fires, misses off the back rim and on the rebound, a whistle and a foul here. It's gonna be called, I think, on Becca Smith. Nope, check that. It's gonna be on Ariel Beavers. Thought the official held up 2-3, was 2-4, and now, as a matter of fact, Becca Smith coming into the game for the Ramblers. Lindsey Booker comes out. To the line, Chelsea Small here. She is 3-for-3 from the line of the ball game. Free throw on the way and in. Small, check that. She was 3-for-4 before that free throw. She missed her first one before making 3 in a row. Now she's 4-for-5. It's a 61-52 ball game. Here's the second free throw. Good. Small converts. That makes it a 61-53 game. Still work to do here for the Ramblers. Looking for the victory on their home court here at the Gentile Arena. Hambrick right of the circle. Looks in deep to the line. Contact and a foul here. Chelsea Small did not react well. And the reason why is because she got called for the foul. Her fourth, Troy Hambrick now to the line for the Ramblers. Hambrick to shoot two. She's 2-for-2 from the line of the game. Free throw in, route and in. Troy with her 27th point of the game. Hambrick, another one on the way. And it's off the front of the rim, no good. And the rebound to Chelsea Small. So Troy Hambrick misses her first free throw in 4 attempts in the ball game today. Here's a 3 from the corner. That'll miss, and Molly Crosby with a rebound for Loyola. Ariel Beavers across the line. Picked up the dribble, I think, a little bit prematurely there. Here's Hambrick. That will not go. Went around and out, and Littleton the rebound. Abdul Kadir in the front court pulling up. In and out. Rebound tipped around. Whistle here. If it's a held ball situation, it'll be Indiana State to keep it on the arrow. No, they call the foul here on Chelsea Small, I believe. And she's out of the game. Small with her 5th personal foul. Small leaves unofficially with 12 points in the game and 3:58 to go. Take another look here. There's the shot by Abdul Kadir. Kind of rattled in and out. And I thought, to be honest with you, that was going to be called a jump ball, but it didn't go Indiana State's way. So we've got a timeout on the floor, 3:58 to go. Ramblers the lead, 62-53. We'll take a break and return on LoyolaRamblers.com.
Rambler fans, did you know that by joining the Rambler Varsity Club, you are directly ensuring the future success and growth of the Loyola athletic programs? Your support helps provide championship-level experiences for student-athletes through educational support, facilities upgrades, and providing each team with the tools they need to succeed. Please join the Rambler Varsity Club and share in the success of the Rambler athletics community. Become a member today by calling 773-508-3321. Or join online at LoyolaRamblers.com.
Caputo Cheese Market has just the cheese you're looking for. With over 1,000 cheeses from around the world, Caputo Cheese Market supplies only the finest and freshest cheeses at wholesale price. Caputo Cheese Market also offers a full-service deli, a sausage shop specializing in homemade sausages. The market also has a focacceria that sells pastries, cannolis, cookies, and more, plus specialty food items from Europe. Caputo Cheese Market is located at 1931 North 15th Avenue in Melrose Park, just north of North Avenue on 15th in Melrose Park.
A handshake. It's a simple gesture. It can greet an old friend or make a new one. It says, welcome, best of luck. I'm here if you need me. It has a power to make a new place, well, feel like home. You're always among friends at Loyola University Chicago, where extraordinary lives begin.
Back at the Gentile Arena on this Super Bowl Sunday 2014. And Troy Hambrick coming out of the break. We'll go to the line here. Troy right now with 27. That's a season and career high. First free throw around and in. Hambrick. Now 4 for 5 from the line. Second one. No miss off the right side of the rim. Nice rebound by LaShonda Littleton. Abdul Qadir down the lane. To the hoop. And a foul in deep. 3:52 remaining here in the contest. Becca Smith called for the foul, her third. Team's 9. And Bilqis Abdul-Qadir back to the line here now for Indiana State. First free throw here goes in. These are almost now to the point where they are must-make free throws. Another look here on the drive toward the hoop. And the foul. Crowd making noise. Second free throw right there. Abdul Qadir unfazed. That makes it 63-55. Ariel Beavers into the forecourt up the far sideline as you watch on our LoyolaRamblers.com video stream. The picture has been fine. The voice, not so good today. Travel here and Indiana State to get it back. 3:37 remaining here in this second half. And the Sycamores to move it all the way, left or right. Abdul Qadir in the front court. Works it around the high screen set by Littleton. Johnson out front. Left side now Munn. Abdul Qadir drives. Her shot blocked by Troy Hambrick. Ball loose near sideline. Great effort by the Ramblers there. Becca Smith going after the loose ball, but couldn't get to it in time, and Indiana State to keep it. Little bump there on the inbound, but no foul. And Abdul Qadir spins left of the lane, put it up, and that'll miss off the back of the rim. Rebound goes to Molly Crosby. Long pass in deep, and the short shot goes in. Actually, a lay-in to be accurate. As Lindsay Booker, she has 5. 65-55, Ramblers by 10. I guess you could say a layup is a short shot. Anyway, 2:45 for the game. Boy, the Ramblers have been clamping down defensively every game. Almost every possession in this game, I should say. And they get the rebound after a pair of misses there, and the Ramblers have possession back. Ariel Beavers wide left. Hambrick trying to set the screen. Beavers in deep. Tosses it back to the right. Oh, it got tipped, I think, by Abdul Qadir into the hands of Becca Smith. And out front, three ball in dead center for Lindsay Booker. Her second three-point field goal of the game. Ramblers up 68-55, and Indiana State wants time. And the crowd loves it here at the Gentile Arena. 30-second timeout. We'll stay here. Ramblers out to a 13-point lead. Have another look here. Boy, she was wide open. Nobody was anywhere near her. There was at least a 6-foot radius of free space around Lindsay Booker there, and she just drained the shot. So the Ramblers trying to close in on their 9th win of the year overall. They would be 5-4 in the Missouri Valley. Indiana State now in danger of losing their 8th game of the year. And they will drop to 7-2 in the Missouri Valley. Back with you here on the Rambler Network. on the 21st of February. Ramblers have three games before the next home game on the road. The next three games are against Missouri State, Wichita State, and Bradley. Indiana State needs a quick poop off the inbound, and they won't get one. Instead, we're going to have a foul here called on Bilkis Abdul-Kadir. That'll be her third. Check that, her fourth, I beg your pardon. Nope, it'll be her third. And anyway, Ariel Beaver's on the line, and she misses the first free throw. I hit her with three. And so do the stats discrepancy here now as to how many fouls. And it is determined that it is Abdul-Kadir's third personal foul. So that piece of business has been taken care of, and we're ready to resume. Second free throw by Beavers right there. Ariel Beavers misses the first, makes the second. She has 3 points today. Ramblers up 14, 69-55. Little spin move, and then the shot. That'll miss there for Rachel Mahan. Here's Troy Hambrick veering through traffic into the front court.